Welcome to part 7 of the Wig-Wag engine build. In this video, I'll be making the engine crank disc. Now, the original design was based on my wooden prototype, as seen here, but on future models, I simplified this design to have a 90-degree cutout on the crank to make the machining process easier with less mounting setups, especially if machining in a vertical slide on the lathe. So today, I will make the alternative design as on page 5A of the plans. First of all, a 10mm slice of 40mm round brass bar was cut off to length, and this was mounted up in the lathe and faced off ready for marking out and drilling using the same techniques as the flywheel build. This was then reamed out to 6mm, and then the recess turned away as before. Locking compound was then used to secure a 6mm shaft into the crank disc and set aside for a couple of hours to set. This was then faced down to the required dimensions, and the outer diameter was finely skimmed down to clean metal, as this was already a 40mm bar to start with, so I didn't want to remove any more metal than was really necessary. The final diameter was measured and noted down so that the dimensions could be calculated and transferred accurately with the scribe. The halfway points were scribed on the disc, and measurements also scribed for the milling operations to allow for the 6mm radius into the corners. Firstly though, the reamed hole for the connecting pin required drilling out whilst the job was in the V-block, so this was set up in the drill press and drilled and reamed to size. Now, drilling brass can be problematic with regular drills, so I keep a set of drills which have had the cutting edges ground off to a negative angle to prevent the drills from snatching into the workpiece. That was a bit nasty. The reamed hole was tested for size with the 4mm pin stock. Okay. A 12mm four flute end mill was set up in the mill, and the crank disc was mounted up in the vise using a square to eyeball against the scribe line to ensure it was set up squarely. This was then machined away to the scribe lines, and then the end mill was swapped out for my ball nose cutter, and the radius is formed into the corners. The chemical bond was then released using heat, and when cooled down, the crank disc was tidied up with a small needle file. The crank pin was then sawn to length and the ends cleaned up in the lathe. The pin will be set in the hole later using Loctite, but for now that's the crank disc fully machined, so it's time to move on to the next process. My first wigwag was designed to run clockwise when looking at the flywheel, so I decided to build this one to run in the opposite direction. This is dictated by the positioning of the input and the exhaust tubes, but this can of course be configured however you like, and to suit your particular air or steam supply. These were marked out and drilled to suit my 3/16 exhaust pipe and my 1/8 of an inch supply pipe, which suits my 4mm air supply. Some 800 grit wet and dry paper was then used to clean up any imperfections on the face of the support column and also on the cylinder contact face to make sure that they are good and flat. It is advised to use a figure of eight rotating pattern against the abrasive paper, although this takes some practice to master. And if you've ever seen me on the dance floor, you would know holding a rhythm just isn't one of my speciality talents. You're more likely to find me in the bar. A bowl of hot soapy water and a pipe cleaner was then used to make sure that all the traces of abrasive dust was thoroughly washed away from all the components. The press fit bearings can now be fitted to the support column, and these are given a drop of oil to ease this process and then taken to the vise. Some aluminium angle was fitted to the jaws and a slip of paper to cover the port face to prevent marking, and the pivot bearing was pressed in. The main bearing required a standoff spacer, and a small brass plug was also used so that I could see the depth of the insertion. And this was pressed home, leaving approximately 1.5 millimeters protrusion from the crank side. The cylinder cap was also pressed in to cap off the top of the cylinder. So there we are, a full set of Wig-Wag components, all ready for final assembly. So I hope you'll join me again in the final episode, where I can put the engine together and give it its first breath of life. Thanks for watching.